Every year, the archdiocese had what they call a Mission Sunday. They invite someone in from one of the places of the world that need help, and invite them to speak to the community of faith assembly. Now, this week, we have with us Father Gonzalo from Mexico, and because he is limited in his English, his confrere, Javier Castillo, will give the reflection in his name. I invite you to welcome both of them.
Good morning. First of all, thank you, Father John and Father George, who are welcoming here in the parish, and to all of you for receiving us. And a special welcome, since yesterday back at Mass, we felt and we feel it really welcome, even part of the family. And secondly, my name is Javier Castillo, Father George Mission. I'm working in the Archdiocese of Chicago in the new office, the new structure, the Life of Formation Coordinator. I've been in the Archdiocese for 5 years, and this office is the same sequence with the Office of Catechesis and Youth Ministry. Father Gonzalo, who is originally from Mexico, Texcoco, Mexico, that is 45 minutes north from Mexico City, is nearby to the big pyramids, the Teotihuacan, and he is here because Bruno is representing his bishop and the whole diocese. The diocese of Texcoco is built with 84 parishes. There are 110 priests. And the population in the diocese of Texcoco is 1.5 million people, who are 85% of the population are Catholics. And seeing that there are only 110 priests, that is not enough priests to provide service and bringing evangelization and the joy of the people around the area in the diocese of Texcoco. The diocese is actually the mother of four dioceses, so it was established almost 500 years ago with the Friar Pedro de Gante, who was the founder of Texcoco, and who really established the mission of the church in Texcoco. After that, they continue providing evangelization. Evangelization is not going to be only talking about that, it's even providing the good service, the good attention. In that time, they continue building communities, establishing parishes, even teaching them how to survive during those struggles, especially the colonization time. And they continue working the hard way. Being in the peripheries of Pope Francis has been saying, those are really the poor areas. Now the people are moving from the small towns to different parts of the Mexico, and they are coming to the city. So basically, in geographically talking, it's a small area, but it's a huge community that they have to serve. And they are providing the service every year. And to complete the service and the mission, continue the mission of the church, they need to provide formation to the lay people, to the communities. This formation is the continued formation in the parishes, establishing a special group of missionaries who are going to continue service even in the path they move from one parish to another one, so they are going to continue working in their home parishes. And this formation is for 3 years and continue providing this information. And especially not going out, knocking the doors, inviting people to come and hear the joy of the gospel, to hear about Jesus Christ. And continue talking to the today's reading, and basically from the gospel acclamation, when they say, take my joy upon you, say the Lord, and learn from me, for I am meek and humble of heart. When we, as Pope Francis has been saying, when we have empty our hearts, when we have empty our souls, it's going to be a space for Jesus Christ. August 28, the church is celebrated St. Augustine. And St. Augustine used to say, love and do whatever you want. It's through the love, through love, which actually we invite Jesus Christ in our hearts is when we open ourselves and let Jesus Christ to be the center in our lives. And when we are bringing Jesus Christ into our hearts, we're going to be able to share love, compassion, service, to live, to forget, and to love our brothers and sisters. It's something really interesting from the Gospel when we say, rather than you hold a banquet, invite the poor. And it's something that really gives us a challenge for all of us, especially when we are just really comfortable in our lives. What else do I need? I'm okay, I'm fine. Yes, but Jesus Christ is all the time inviting us to be a different person, to be a different people. And something really interesting is about a definition from Pope Francis. Who's a Christian? A Christian is a person who build bridges, no walls. And the question that I encourage you to reflect, I'm being a good person, I'm building bridges, or I'm building walls. How is my relationship with my brothers and sisters? How is my relationship with my brother in front of me, behind me, or behind my side? I'm really helping them. I forgive them and I forget and forgive them what they do to me. I do what Jesus Christ invited me to do. Those are the questions that I invited us to do it. And at the same time, be a missionary. Not necessarily we have to go all the way to these poor parents and meet, but we can support them in our prayers. We can support them with our sacrifices here, from here. We can teach, share, and invite others to be part of the disciples of Jesus Christ. We have to empty our hearts. We have to let a real space to ourselves. In that way, Jesus Christ is going to be with us, and we're going to be able to go outside and preach the gospel with our actions. On behalf of Father Gonzalo and Monsignor from my brother Mancilla, his bishop, we really thank you for the offer of your prayers, and secondly, for your donation. Your donation will be helping a lot of brothers and sisters in the diocese of Texcoco, who are going to be receiving the information, and they're going to be going out to proclaim the gospel, the joy of our hearts, Jesus Christ. Thank you very much. God bless you.